So back in March, a couple of months ago, our Democratic colleagues passed a spending bill that provided $5 billion for emergency housing vouchers to be distributed to people experiencing homelessness, victims of human trafficking, and other circumstances. Under that law and HUD's own regulations, illegal immigrants are not eligible for these vouchers. But just yesterday, Fox Business reported that HUD recently issued guidance that will have the effect of making it easier for illegal immigrants to obtain these emergency housing vouchers that are supposed to be meant for Americans. This happens because, as I understand it, the new guidance waives an existing HUD regulation that requires public housing authorities to obtain and verify documentation that an applicant for a housing voucher actually has a legal immigration status as opposed to an illegal status at the time of application. HUD's own regulations say that this requirement, the one that HUD is waiving, if this report is accurate, this requirement is meant to, quote, decrease the incidence of fraud, waste, and abuse, end quote. HUD's guidance may now allow illegal immigrants to obtain these housing vouchers that, as I said, are meant for American citizens. So Secretary Hudge, isn't it important that we follow the law and the HUD regulation and have processes in place to minimize the risk that these vouchers go to people who are not supposed to have them?
Yes, Senator, indeed it is. And I thank you for the question. I think that it is very, very clear from our May 5th public notice detailing the operating requirements for the Emergency Housing Vouchers Program. It is clear that in line with current law, eligibility for assistance is limited to United States citizens and those with legal residency.
Right, but I'm concerned that this guidance, by waiving this rule that HUD has historically used to minimize the risk that illegal immigrants have these vouchers, by waiving this, isn't it going to increase the risk that illegal immigrants will end up obtaining these housing vouchers that are meant for U.S. citizens?
I do not believe that it will do that in any significant way, Senator. I think that to say that would assume that every single illegal resident wants to come in and scam the system. That is not how this works. People who are homeless generally do not have identification. They do not have their Social Security cards, et cetera. And so what we have done is allowed our housing authorities and partners to come up with ways to allow them to at least initially report themselves to self-certify, and then we verify.
Okay,
and so if we find that someone is in the system that should not be, we certainly will take care
right.
of
it. Right. And that, so first of all, my question does not in any way imply that everyone who's here illegally is looking for these vouchers. There's no such suggestion. I'm simply saying that if there is not an opportunity to screen out people who are not actually eligible, if we don't have that mechanism, then there is likely to be some abuse of this system. And it would inevitably will take months at best to discover and then litigate and adjudicate these cases. I would just urge you to reconsider this. This is HUD's own regulation that's being waived is described by HUD as serving the purpose of decreasing incidents of fraud, waste, and abuse. So I would just ask you.
I'm certainly willing to do so, sir. I will take another look at it.
I appreciate that. The other thing is we've got in the administration's so-called infrastructure plan calls for $40 billion more for public housing. And, you know, in many cases, public housing has become places where people don't really want to live. There are notorious stories of concentrations of poverty and crime and other social ills. And there's research that shows that families who move out of these projects often are able to integrate themselves in communities. There's lower risk that they'll be victims of crime. It seems that there are sensible alternatives. And in fact, some of these projects are in such a state of disrepair that the cost of repairing them is greater than the cost that it would incur of just providing vouchers for people to live in good, decent homes. What are your thoughts on shifting some of this resource to providing vouchers for low-income people?
Sir, you know what, Senator? I agree with you 100%. The problem is that we have people who live in public housing now, and we do not have enough housing for the demand. And so we still have to take care of the people who are in public housing. And that's what this $40 billion will do. I mean, for many, many years, we have not invested significantly in capital needs of public housing. And so what you have is buildings that are more than 50 years old, the majority of them, that are in different stages of disrepair. And so even though I agree that we do need to find ways to move people into other housing in communities with better opportunities, we still have to deal with the issue we currently have. And that's what the $40 billion will do.